David began as any apprentice unloading lumber, in this case, rare Cuban mahogany logs into the workshop. His father carefully guided his son to learn the needed skills and to eventually manage the workshop. When David was 25 and his father was 55, their furniture was known throughout Europe. Many knew the reputation for the high-quality mahogany with bronze imported from Birmingham, England. Clients loved to discover that most of the casework had secret compartments and drawers. Female clients loved to purchase the delicate inlays of flowers that were made from small pieces of various colored wood.
Count, you want to see our treasures? Frederick? Count? You missed him, boy.
And as usual, within a few days, his father came up with a new design for next year's show.
Well, what if we build them a little tea chest? We'll put a little black and green leaves in separate metal canisters and surround them with a pretty mahogany box.
In a few days, we had produced our first prototype. And David confirmed that he was a good salesman. So when Count Philip Waldendorf roared down the corridor of the Franklin furniture trade,
Count, did you see what the prince bought? All royalty is jealous of this luxurious tea set. Come and see it.
Over the next several years, the Roentgens provided over 24 pieces into the bishop's residence. At the beginning of the year, David called together his employees to discuss several items.
My first topic is to reach one of my long-term goals to expand our marketplace beyond Germany. I will continue my relationship with King Frederick, and I'll be seeking letters of introduction in Paris and St. Petersburg. So, if your family knows of friends or relatives in these capitals, seek information that can help us create products that are needed by the upper class. My second topic is the result of work between my father and the head of Marquetry. They have developed this light portable table suitable for the parlor or the bedroom. Knowing my father, you should not be surprised that there will be a few hidden compartments. Revealing a beautiful writing surface. And do we have some fabulous decorations? We'll continue to add bronze decorations from Birmingham, England. And from our marquetry and veneer department, staff will glue pieces of veneer together and trace on the needed pattern. Now this table features a beautiful array of delicate flowers on the top. And a flower with a French flourish on the side. So let's give them a round of applause. Now, to reach entrance to the palace in Paris or St. Petersburg with this desk or the other treasures will take a lot of sweat and a lot of effort. They say it's an era of politics, intrigue, and love. I hope you will pass on news from these capitals that will help us. Your information can make a change in a piece of furniture that will really be appreciated. And remember, I appreciate any information about a border guard or agent that would look the other way and help us avoid unnecessary taxes or duties. My final note returns the maps that I opened with. These new markets are a long way away, and if our wagons travel in the winter, we slow down to 7 miles a day. In conclusion,
oh, these letters are from Paris. Well, that's helpful.
Yeah, he's writing scientists about mechanical locks.
Hey, seeing how easy we got this information, let's keep our furniture projects behind locked doors. And Mr. Baumhammer, how is your project?
Well, we're making our roll-top desk for the King's correspondence and his unique locks.
Oh, hi, boss. For the Queen, I'm creating a music box for a mechanical device called an autotron that will play a musical instrument.
In 29 days, David and his crew in the wagon arrived in Paris and set up a furniture display.
Magnifique.
He saw a beautiful mahogany roll-top desk with many drawers and marquetry that celebrated Chinese life. The king loved it and offered 800,000 lira and placed the desk in his study. He then ordered more furniture to be placed in the palace. Shh! Everybody be quiet!
Why, it looks like me.
The queen was astonished by this autotron that played music from Christopher Gluck that Marie had met in Austria. She offered $500,000 for the purchase. She later donated it to the Academy of Science. His Majesty then awarded David the title of Cabinet Maker and Mechanical Engineer to the King and told Peter he was the King's Clock Maker.
It says that the Queen refused to get in her carriage without her dogs. This one says that Catherine is obsessed with the Greek god Apollo.
Wow. So with all that, what do we make for our Empress?
Well, putting together the clues, I'd like to create a large desk with Greek colonnades or hidden music cylinders. It's got to have a lot of bells and whistles.
Yeah, I'd slip in a half a dozen just to be sure.
Then our caravan began its journey.
About halfway through, we lost a few horses and had to abandon some wagons. Then a snowstorm came out of the east. It was a miracle that we lost no stock, no furniture, or any staff.
Then when we got to the rest stop, we learned that David's letter of introduction had been read to the Empress.
Your Majesty, this letter is from Baron Grimm, your Parisian correspondent. It reads, "May I tell you about a man who is on his way to St. Petersburg? It is Monsieur Rendick, undoubtedly the best cabinet maker of this century. He is leaving his large establishment to bring you a piece of furniture to your Majesty's attention. It is unique, and it has been built especially for you. He asks nothing better than to submit to your Majesty's judgment. I beg you to favor him by inspecting his work, because this alone is the purpose of his journey."
David's carriage went directly to the Hermitage Art Museum. She led David down Raphael's corridor. In the morning, it was the Empress's opportunity to be surprised.
Oh, David, it's from you. It's beautiful.
My Empress, we have made you a cabinet that is topped by a statue of Apollo. It is intended to hold letters and fitted with a large number of mechanisms to open drawers, a reading stand, and to turn on music. The bureau's mechanics was created by our chief engineer, Peter Kingsen, and plays music recorded by Jonathan Ware. We hope that is worthy of your attention and can become an addition to this fine museum.
David, I'm in love with this piece. I'm awarding you 200,000 rubies for this masterpiece. That's the equivalent of the price of a country estate. And my staff, always aware of all activities across Mother Russia, will present you with a list of 150 pieces that I require to furnish my palaces. I expect that you will deliver these items in 4 separate trips to St. Petersburg in the next 7 years. And as I've told my boyfriend, I expect all the furniture will arrive safely and at the right moment to satisfy my glut.